Hello, 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 all. I am back. Today, my topic is to touch bases on the church community. Unfortunately, some people, as targeted individuals, our people in general, have had bad experiences which left doubt about the church houses, church homes, church community. And also, due to bad experience within the church home, it has weakened some people's faith. So I'm here to tell you that I acknowledge your truth and understand why some of you have stopped being committed to the church homes, because a lot of false prophets are sheeps and wolf closings that are preaching the word to you. And unfortunately, it has left a bad taste in your mouth that led you to stray away from communicating or congregating within a church home. It's unfortunately over the years the churches have changed. If you think about it, many people was taught that by engaging in the duty of a church home, it can help heal your sins. Therefore, within a church, most of the people that are tend are the ones fighting demons. Think about it. Most of the people that are attending are fighting their own demons and our issues. So, therefore, if you come in there openly and confess your sins, those that are fighting demons will like to relieve the guilt from themselves and cast stones at you. So, therefore, for someone to hear any gossip about someone that's in a negative manner, what they're going to do, let's cast stones. Why? Because it made them feel better as a human. It's just as the saying goes, when you were taught, bullies bully other people because they are battling some type of some kind of issue of their own. So what makes them feel good is by bullying others. So the same thing goes within these church homes. There's a lot of people battling demons within these church houses. And so when they hear somebody else is battling something, they cast stones because it makes them feel like, he without sin cast the first stone. My sin is not that bad, so let me talk down on this person to make myself feel better. However, many churches are perceived to be perfect, and they're assumed that, sins or issues don't exist. The churches and its member gives off false images that they are perfect. However, instead of churches shunning those that are seeking help, they should be a place that provides an open platform for those who seek help to be able to address these issues freely. So you may wonder, like, well, where did this all come from? Why do people feel the need that they have to go to church in order to release their sins? Because we have to remember, when you refer to the Bible in Matthew's 11, 28 and 30, it states, "Come to me, all ye who are weary and I burden and I, excuse me, and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble." So when it says come to me, most people think, well, how do I come to Jesus? Most people believe I have to encounter the Lord by attending the church. But you don't understand that you can get in your zen and come to the Lord with your problems in the comfort of your home, the comfort of your car, in the bathroom, in the break room. It doesn't take you to lay down your sins and talk to God within the church. But also, you have to remember that it says in Matthew 18:20, which is why people feel the church home is the right place to be. It says in Matthew 18 and 20, "For where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am amongst them." So with that being interpreted, it is taught that it was our duty to gather together in honor of Jesus and Christ. So what's the right place to gather together? And the church home. However, the church has turned a blind eye to remembering that passage, and it has created a platform of negativity. So a lot of people don't feel like gathering amongst those that they feel are going to slander them or point the finger at them. So instead of people slandering one another within a church home, we supposed to embrace each other. The church is supposed to be a platform provided for those of us that need help to gain help. So those of you that are still members in support of the church system, please understand that a lot of people are straying away from the churches because they feel that a church is a place where you have to pay in order to receive a blessing. You feel that you have to be perfect in order to attend this church. You feel that you have to wear fancy clothing in order to be a member of a church. If you guys take away that stigma, I guarantee you the church doors will be open freely again, with people gathering in and flocking together to come and gather as one in honor of Jesus' name. Overall, Hebrews 10:25 states, let us not give up meeting together. Let us encourage one another. So how can we encourage one another from a distance? The only way I feel to encourage you guys and to keep that saying alive is by doing these videos. I encourage you to live life. I encourage you to gather together. We live in a world, in a society where they're trying to take away religion, period. They're trying to take away our faith, period, and let us only have faith in man, which that's a lie. Can't do it. Like, they're starting to spread the rumors that slavery was intended or a tactic of a biblical, I don't know the word I'm trying to say. I'm lost. I'm rambling. Sorry. But they're trying to say that within the Bible that Jesus condoned slavery. However, if you refer to Exodus, the 21st chapter 16 verse, it says anyone who kidnaps someone is to be put to death, whether the victim has been sold or is still in kidnapper's possession, should be put to death. Okay. And also it says in Exodus 21 through the 26th verse, any owner who hits a male or female slave in the eye and destroy it must let the slaves go free. Okay, I know you guys are saying why they use the term slave. You have to understand, back in the days, okay, when the Bible was created, people were able to turn over themselves to be slaves in order to pay off debt. Meaning, I was able to go to someone and says, you know what, I owe the courts, the law, money. So I want to work to pay this off. And that, and you will become a slave, so you will have a master. So when they say this word, slaves and master, they're referring to those of you that gave yourself to slavery. This is before the Americans, humans that are in sin, took over the slavery tactics. Some people took the word slave and ran with it and credit their own. Unfortunately, the people that were masters by enforcing slavery were the ones that lied to the slaves and said, you know, they was like false prophets. Those are the ones who took advantage and flipped everything, just like how people took advantage of the things that are going on within the world today, within the world of the gang stalking. Gang stalking was back in the days were in order to get our enemies, meaning those that were coming against our country that's going to attack us. They took it and used it in their own evil demise spirits and took it and ran with it and tried to control America, which is not a good thing. So that's the same thing with slavery. People heard a method of slavery, took over, and evil spirits took it in and start beating and hurting people in order to work for them. So we got to understand that the Bible does not condone slavery. Once again, Exodus, it says, anyone who kidnaps someone is to be put in death, whether it's a victim has been sold or is still in a kidnapper's possession, meaning it is not right to own someone as a possession. So therefore, stop letting these people put in your head that, oh, slavery was due to the Bible. Not true. It was due to man taking over words and twisting it and making it into an evil condition. Because if you look it up, people were able to turn themselves into slaves in order to pay off debt to the rich and will say, you know what, I don't have the money, but can I work for you? And I will pay off my debt. So we must come together and understand the truth and always seek our own knowledge and wisdom. And also, I want you guys to look into another term for organized gang stalking is the Phoenix Program. Yes, the Phoenix Program. I just came across that. So please look into that and figure out what that's all about. And if you get any more information, always, you know, submit it so I can look into it. But which is, I got a weird story about the Phoenix Program. That's going to be another topic. I hope I wasn't just running at the mouth. And I promise to keep in touch and pray for you as you pray for me. Enjoy the rest of your day. Gain control of your life. Don't let them control you. You have control over your happiness and everything that you do. Talk to you guys later.